Okay, now let's start from the beginning again, right? Let's go back. Let's go to find menu and close all, okay? Close all. And we say, no, 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 we do not want to save anything. Okay, let's go back to Illustrator, okay? Now, we're going to create a logo here together, okay? You must create as simple as my logo, okay? Otherwise, if you try something different, maybe, you know, this might not get the same result. So what to do? Okay, let's start with the first shape with the polygon, right? So I'm going to create a simple polygon with the star on the center. Okay, that is my star right here, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to select both objects, right? And align to center, align vertically. Okay, that's it. Oops. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So everyone have this shape, right? Yes? Or no? So we got this shape, right? It's only two shapes. One is a base, and another one a star. A polygon and a star. That's it. And then if we export or we save this, you know, in the single file, right, in the single file, what you're going to have, you're going to have a polygon with the hole of star, right? The star will become transparency. But if you save separate, for example, if I save separate, I select the star and hit delete, okay, hit delete, right? And I'm going to save as the logo Friday one, okay? Save as the logo Friday one, Illustrator A. Okay, and then I undo that, undo clear, and I go to select, leave inwards, right? And delete the polygon. Now I go to file, save as logo Friday two, okay? So basically, one is the polygon, one is the star. Okay. One file is the polygon file, and one file is the star.
Did you delete the polygon?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Number one is the polygon only. Number two is the star only. Yeah. That's it. Basically, but the reason I said, you know, form the same file, because normally your logo is not going to have only two elements, okay? Your logo going to have a few elements together, right? So this means you probably want to organize everything, you know, and then save it separately, yeah? If you want to be a separate object. But of course, if I save it simultaneously, it's become a single object, okay? Okay, now, you have logo one right here, right? With the polygon, and logo two, you have with the star, okay? Now, after you finish saving, right? You got to make sure you save as Illustrator A, otherwise you won't be able to open it up, right? Okay, so now you come to here. Go to File menu, go to come to Cinema 4D, go to File menu and open, and then you select logo number one, which is a polygon, right? And you go to Extrude Nerve, select Extrude Nerve, right? And drag the logo, the polygon, into Extrude Nerve and release. So you see the Extrude Nerve was extended. And then, of course, on the extrude nerve, you can add the filler cap, right? To make it look nicer, okay? Yeah, that's it. And you're doing the same thing with the star. Go to File and open. And logo number two, right? And go to extrude nerve. Drag the star. Okay, by the way, I can change the name on this by double click on it, and I can change this to S-T-A-R, okay? So you know, the name will make more sense, right? And then I can drag into that. And of course, when I select extruder, I can fill the cap, right? Fill the cap on that, okay? And then I'm going to copy, go to window, right? And paste on the base, yeah. And after that, right? After that, I move the start forward a little bit. Okay, anyone not follow, raise your hand and go to the last queue. Okay, you got the, yeah. So first you have to click extruder and then you drag it into that, right? See extruder and then you go to cap, change the fillet cap. So now you see your object. Nice, right? And you can copy, select that, copy, and go to another object doing the same thing. Yeah. Okay, and you. Okay, all right, look good though. What you do, right? Now you already have two objects, right? You make this a little bit bigger, and then you select your star, right? You move it a little bit forward. You see how much forward you want? And how are you doing? Your star still... Oh, look good. Yeah. Okay. How about you, Arya? Pengeman? Arya? How about you, Arya? Guys, you're on this step, right? Now, we're going to talk about the material, okay? Everyone look on the screen, okay? Look on the screen. I'm going to want you to take a look first, and then you have to do it later. Now, look on the screen first. First, you have to go to create, okay? Create your material, okay? Go to create, right here. Right, and say new material, okay? And all the default material is red, green, and blue, right? If I want a gold color, what the combination of gold color in red, green, and blue?
Red, green, and blue.
Yeah, what the combination of red, green, and blue to have a gold color? Can you tell me? Cannot, I cannot too. Okay. So what you do, right? What you do, right? You change red, green, and blue to HSV, right? New, what the S stands for, extra credit. You already learned that in Photoshop.
Saturation.
Saturation, what's your number?
11.
11. 11? Okay, take me. And what the V stand for?
Value.
Raise your hand for your answer.
Value.
Value. Number?
8.
8. Good. So, what do you think? If you use, if you select your color from hue, right? It's much easier, right? Because hue is the color. So if I want to make it gold, right? So I move the gold. But right now I move it to gold, but doesn't look gold. Why? Because the saturation is zero, right? Zero is black and white. So yeah, now you have to increase saturation to 100, right? So now you got a little bit of gold, right? A little bit of orange. And then you increase the value up to 100, right? Does it look gold to you? Right? Something like that? Okay. So now, this is the basic color. You see, when you create a new material, right? You see the material is pop up here, right? And what you can control by the basic. You come to the basic, okay? Click on the basic, and you see what basic you have, right? On the basic, you have, basically you have a color, right? You have luminance, you have reflection, you have fog, normal, spectra, grow, diffuse, transparency, environment, bump, alpha, spectra, and displacement, okay? So you have overwhelming of feature that you want to select on that. But now my idea is I want to make it look gold, right? So basically, what the quality of gold?
Shiny.
Yeah, shiny, yes. What the shiny?
Grow.
Not quite though. Grow is mean, you know, it's not a gold. It's become an LED, you know, it has some emitting light, right? Yeah, so it's got to be a reflection, right? Reflection is have some reflection, right? It's gold, not transparency. Gold is a solid, right? So you might want to add some reflection on that. So what you do, you click the correct mark on reflection and you see what happened. You select reflection, right? And you click the check mark on reflection. And when you check the quick check on reflection, right? What you have, the reflection option pop up here, right? So you tap on reflection, okay? You tap on reflection. The reflection brightness right now is 100%. Reflection brightness is now 100%, okay? So it doesn't look like gold. It looks like a chrome, right? It's too much. So now we change the reflection brightness. Reflection brightness on the reflection tab. So we change it to 10% and enter. That's it, right? So just a little bit of reflection. If you put it the whole thing, right, it's become like a mirror. You don't want to make it look like mirror, okay? So now my reflection is look nice, right? So now how I apply this, you have two ways to apply. First, you can drag this to the to the whatever you want on the viewport, okay? Drag the material, drop on whatever you want on the viewport, or drag it on this manager window, okay? So now I always like to drag it on to the viewport sometimes, so I drag it on the viewport, okay? And let me explain one more thing, right? On here, you see icon on the top, right? It's moving object, right? In different view, but you see this slate icon right here, right? You see play icon? There are total of three icons right here. Start with the left one. The left one is the first fast preview, okay? So the fast preview, what the fast preview? When you select and you click play, this is the give me the quick preview, okay? Right here on this button. And the center button is the start actual rendering, okay? Start actual rendering, which is you probably do not want to press it yet. And the last one is the render option. This last one is the render option. So when we finish it, right, this render option, when we finish it, we're going to, you know, talk about it, how we're going to render it. Okay, any question? Hungry? Thirsty? Or need a toilet?
Okay.
Alright, almost though. Let's we finish up and then you can pray now with that in, give me maybe 3 more minutes. Okay, now we got this goal, right? Now I want to make a grass, a blue grass look of this base of polygon, right? So I'm going to create a new material, okay? Create another material, it's called new material, right? And now I'm going to change this to blue color, okay? Give it blue color. And in this particular blue color, right, I want to add a different, okay, I'm going to add a different property. I'm going to add transparency, okay? And the transparency tab, right? Brightness of transparency tab is 20%, okay, 20%. And of course, maybe some of refraction on the basic, so I add some refraction. And on the reflection tab, I add another 20% as well, okay? So now I'm going to drop this blue grass on that polygon, right? And then let me fill up the screen and quick preview. So now I can see my logo with some of refraction, you know, semi-transparency on that, right? Look nice. What do you think? Yeah. Plus, before I let you break, right, I want to add 2 more things, okay? 2 more things. This thing is not going to be perfect yet, right? But I'm going to add 2 more things. Before I add 2 more things, right, I'm going to do something with the material right here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to make a copy of gold color, okay? So I select the gold and copy, okay? Copy and press. You see what happened? Copy and press. So now it's giving me another goal, right? And on this goal here, I can change the color, okay? I can change the color from the goal to maybe, you know, to orange, something like that, right? And then what I like to add is, I'm going to add the floor, okay? The floor object right here, okay? We're going to add the floor object. Okay, let's add the floor object first, okay? Click on the floor. So when you do one click, right? When you do one click, the floor will show up, but you don't know where. How do I supposed to know where? So you have to zoom out, okay? Let's zoom out. Where is the floor, okay? The floor is add to center of the world, okay? Basically, the floor is add right on top of your logo, okay? The floor add on the top of your logo. How do I know? You have to go to the right view and then you click on the zoom out, right? So you can see. And now, what I like to do, right? I like to drop the orange, okay? The orange material to the floor, okay? To the floor, right there. And then I'm going to move the floor down, okay? Move the floor down. You see, when I move the floor down, I know how much the floor can move down, right? To make the logo just stand above the floor, like that. And then I just click quick preview. So it's really orange look, okay? And one last thing before I let you go to break, right? I want to add the light, okay? Add the light on that. Remember in After Effects, right? We also have a camera and the light. So in Cinema 4D, we also have the same thing. You see, on the light here, you see the light? Right there, the light bulb, okay? When you click and hold it, so you're going to see something called target light, okay? You're going to see something called target light. Okay, let's add the target lights. Okay, add the target light. Now, when you add the target light, right? Okay, let's move this right scene a little bit lower. It means you can modify the target of the light, okay? Modify the light itself and modify the target of the light. So now the light is pointing to the center of the world. It's not pointing to your logo. So how do we point it to our logo, right? First, you have to select the target light, okay? Select the target light on the object manager. Okay, so you select the target light, right? And when you select the target light, you see the X, green, red, and blue, right? So this means if the light is targeted to the center of the world right now, it's above the logo, right? So this means you want to move the target light down. So you move the green X, right? Move the green X, which is the Y X, move it down, right? Now I move it down. Okay, to attach to the logo. But right now, it's not straight yet, right? If you look from the top, right, I have to move it a little bit to the right hand, okay? Something like that. So now it's just right on the center of my logo, okay? And what else you can take a look? Look at your light right now, okay? Look at your light right now. What else you can do with the light, okay? Almost there, okay? So now we almost take a break. So we select the light, right? And now you look at the light. What you missing on the light? If you look at the light, right? Select the light and on the light general, you will see the light have the options, okay? One of the options that I like to talk about is something called shadow. Because right now it's weird because the light is casting to your logo, but no shadow. So I want to select the shadow, right? To make a soft shadow, okay? And the visible light, I can make it visible light on that. And I can extend the light a little bit, you know, longer, and make the ray visible light a little bit longer as well. And now the shadow, okay, you tap on the shadow, the density of the shadow I want to add at instead of 100% black, I'm going to make only 50% black, okay. Now I like to render and what it look like. So this is what it look like, okay. Okay, let's take a break for like 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and then you can come back. Yes, if you have questions, go ahead.